today we are looking at the Personas Aeris E5 Studio monitors. Before going on with this review, I want to make one thing clear. I am not a music producer or a music professional or a DJ by any means. However, I do enjoy high-end audio and I consider myself an audio enthusiast. The build quality of these speakers is incredible with its matte black finish, its beautiful Kevlar cone that has this blue tint to it that is just gorgeous, and illuminated logo when the speakers are powered on. Personally, I think these are the best looking 5-inch studio monitors currently on the market. The driver is 5.25 inches in diameter and the tweeter is 1 inch. Looking at the back of these studio monitors is where this speaker really starts to stand out from the rest with all the features that it has on the back. We have the input gain knob that allows you to adjust the gain. You have the ability to adjust the mids by just turning this dial. You can bring down the mids or make them pop and be a lot brighter. So that's a really, really cool feature that you don't see on a lot of other speakers. And you can also do the same things for the highs. The low cutoff has flat, 80 hertz and 100 hertz. Now these speakers actually have a pretty decent bass and actually go down pretty low when it's set on flat. But if you have a subwoofer hooked up, you might want to bump that up to 80 and let the subwoofer take care of all the rest of the low end. Now the acoustic space is probably the most interesting feature about these monitors, and it kind of has a diagram on the bottom that allows you to see what each acoustic space is meant for. However, the acoustic space in my experience tends to only affect the lower end and the bass. So when I have it set on zero in my setup, it sounded a little too bassy, very similar to the KRK, had a lot of bass. But by switching it over to -2, I was able to get a much more flat sound coming out of them. When I switched it to -4, there was like no bass. One of the big reasons why the acoustic tuning features of these studio monitors is incredible because it allows you to get the best sound out of a studio monitor without having the perfect listening environment. So no dampening foam and no, you know, isolation room. It really allows you to adjust these speakers to be the perfect sounding speakers for your setup. Also, on the back of these, you have an RCA input, quarter inch input, and an XLR input. Now, when you compare the Personas to the KRK and the Yamahas, the Personas clearly has a lot more features and functionality when it comes to adjusting. And it was really, really interesting to see how the Personas could get a very similar sounding to the KRKs and then very similar sounding to the Yamaha HS5s. That really is what stood out with these speakers when I was testing them side by side. And for me, the Personas Aeris E5s were definitely more present sounding than the Yamahas and the KRK, and had a much more enjoyable listening experience with these than the other two. So that is really why I picked these speakers. I didn't just go out and buy these speakers and say, these are the speakers for me. No, I went and I tested a lot of speakers before I settled on these. These are priced at the same price point as the KRKs and are $100 cheaper than the Yamahas, landing in that $300 sweet spot. Now, I have spent a lot of time with these studio monitors. I have owned them for over 4 months. I have listened to everything from movies to music to video games, and I am floored and just very pleased with these. Now, when I first got them, I do want to just note that I had a little bit of white noise coming out of my right monitor, and I found that the reason why that was happening was because I had my wireless router placed way too close to the right studio monitor. All I had to do was move it away and it was fine. Nothing else interferes with them. My phone doesn't interfere with them. My wireless keyboard, my wireless mouse, nothing else interfered with them, but that wireless router, for whatever reason, was acting funky with them. Something else I've done with these studio monitors is that I have paired them up with a Timbler T8 by Personas. The same company that makes these makes a 8-inch killer subwoofer. I will be doing a full review of the subwoofer in the upcoming future, so make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you want these studio monitors, there will be a link to them in the description below, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.